In the world of the paranormal, a chosen few are prepared to dedicate their whole lives to the study of alien activity. One of these brave scholars is Nathaniel Barrett, a man who has managed to collect so much evidence in support of the existence of extraterrestrial life that the academic community is now being forced to take him seriously. Nathaniel Barrett is ready to tell his story.
My name's Nathaniel, and I'm a UFO spotter.
Well, I'm testing for alien activity. It's quite simple. You have to get in a squatting position and feel the energy. Hey. I'm not getting anything at the moment though, it's quite dry here.
Hey.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt you. I don't suppose you've seen this alien, have you?
No.
What's that in your hand there? It's a photo. I took it at a sighting of one of the aliens I caught, and I enlarged the face to see the detail, and I want to show it to the public to see if they recognise it. That's basically it. Excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt you. I don't suppose you've seen this alien, have you? Oh,
I've not been looking for anybody like that.
Excuse me, sorry to interrupt you. I don't suppose you've seen this alien, have you? excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt you. I don't suppose you've seen this alien, have you? Excuse me, sorry to interrupt you. I don't suppose you've seen this alien.
Yeah, I saw him the other day still.
Right. Yeah, so I need to know where he is.
You want to know where he is? He's jamming at my yard for the time being.
Thanks. Okay. Excuse me? Sorry to bother you, I don't suppose you've seen this alien anywhere? I'm trying to find him. Excuse me, I don't suppose you've seen this alien, have you?
Excuse me, have you got a book called Aliens No Joke by Nathaniel Barrett?
No. Nathaniel?
Nathaniel Barrett. Aliens No Joke?
No, I haven't heard of that one.
Aliens Wise Up?
No.
Have you seen this alien?
No, I haven't, have you?
Yeah, I haven't, sir.
I need to find it. Please, I'm serious.
Yes, I'm sure you are, but I haven't, honestly.
Nowhere?
I'm sure I would have noticed him.
Would you keep a lookout for me?
Yeah, I will, definitely.
And if you see him, you'll see me wandering around in the future, and if you just tell me.
I will.
Thank you very
definitely.
Much. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll tell everybody if I see him.
And if anyone says that they don't believe in aliens, say, wise up.
Right, I'll do that for you.
What is it? Who's that?
It's a special type of alien. It's called Loz.
Loz, yeah. He's alright, he's quite handsome.
Yeah, he's a nice looking alien.
Take him out clubbing with me.
Clubbing? I don't know if he'd like that, but first of all we have to find the man, then we'll introduce him to our culture.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much. Joker. Excuse me, sir? You seen this alien? Sir? You seen this alien? It's no joke! Are you interested in aliens at all?
No, not at all.
I don't suppose you've seen this alien. No, seriously, because I've been, everyone's just been ignoring me and I'm serious about this. I need to find him. No, you sure? Can you have a good look in case?
Yeah, sure.
I'm no alien.
There he is.
Excuse me, have you seen this alien?
No.
Everyone's taking it as a joke. Some people are saying that they've seen it, but I know. Excuse me, have you seen this alien? See, exactly, I mean, they just think it's funny, they think I'm joking around, and some people say they have, but you know they're just joking. I don't know what to do. I shall keep on trying until people understand. Excuse me, have you seen this alien, please? I need to find him. I won't give up, and I'll keep on trying. It's my life.
He's under no illusion that his job will be easy. But news of Nathaniel Barrett's fascinating story is slowly starting to spread.
Well, I was 14, and I think it was Guy Fawkes Night. And I went outside with some friends to look at the fireworks and have a hot potato, you know, the normal things you do on fireworks night. And my friends went home and I was still outside and I was looking up at the night sky and I was thinking, you know, this is beautiful. I was looking, appreciating every star that I could see. And all of a sudden I saw this bright light. Obviously something strange. It was very bright, and I was slightly afraid, and I moved back a bit, and I thought maybe I should go inside, because it was scaring me. It was getting larger, and then all of a sudden this large spaceship, I suppose you'd call it was in the shape of kind of egg shape, came down in my garden and landed. It wasn't very big, about the size of a car, and I was terrified, I was petrified, I didn't know what to do, I was shaking, and out came this little, an alien. It wasn't very big, it was about my height, and I wasn't very big at the age of 14, and I didn't really know what to do, but I thought, I put my hands out, as if to shake its hands, as if to greet it to Earth. I couldn't believe it, I wasn't really thinking clearly, and this creature put out its arm, and it had three fingers. And each finger had a kind of round thing at the top. It, you know, it didn't look anything like a human finger. And I shook its hand. I didn't really say anything. I was just looking at it in amazement. And it was very warm. The creature was very warm. It was making me sweat. And I turned around. I wanted to, you know, get my parents. I wanted them to see this. And then I turned around again. And the ship was going back up to space just in an instant. And I couldn't believe it. It changed my life. From that moment on, I realised why I'm on this planet. I'm here to show everyone, to to show the world, mankind, that there are aliens out there. There's nothing to be afraid of. It's real life. Get with it. They're out there, and they want to be our friends. The aliens were very friendly creatures. They didn't do anything nasty to me. They just wanted to learn something about us, probably, and we need to learn something about them. Well, ever since that day, the very night, actually, when I went back inside, I got out a box. And this box I will give to aliens when I meet them. It's got things that I've had since the age of 14, and I add something every couple of months, and I change it around, because obviously things change. And in this box, I've got some things. I've got rapees, or any rapees. You may sound stupid, you may think it's a bit of a joke, but if they're going to come to our Earth, obviously they're going to be eating our food. So they might get indigestion, so rapees will sort it out, so they will have they won't be in pain when they're eating our food. And this is some of the food they could eat. Reva, I like Reva. I think they'd like Reva because it's pretty neutral taste, sweet. I think they'd enjoy that. Kamikochi, a game. A bit of a joke, really, but something they could do if they get bored on our planet. Water pistol. Also, I suppose, a bit of a joke thing, but, you know, they can play around. Water is, you know, we can't live on this Earth without water, so it'll help them to learn about water, play with water. Malibu. Often, when you invite someone into your house, the first thing you do is give them a drink. So when aliens come to Earth and I meet them, I will give them a drink. So I'm going to give them Malibu. It's a drink I like. A photo of me when I was 14. So if they don't recognise me already, if I meet the same aliens, then hopefully this photo will make them realise that it's me. It's the same me. And hopefully if they don't trust anyone else on Earth, they'll trust me, because they've already met me. Obviously music's an important part of our culture, so here's one of my favourite albums, a classic, Revolver, the Beatles. Everyone likes the Beatles, so if aliens gonna like any sort of music on this Earth, I think they'd like the Beatles, so I'd give them this.
Since his encounter, the study of alien behaviour worldwide has been Nathaniel's only occupation. But as well as gaining knowledge, he has collected hard evidence.
After being in the business a while, you know the best places to spot UFOs, which are on hills, air bases. If you go out into the country, you're more likely to spot a UFO because there's less light pollution. There's a clearer night sky, so everything's more defined in the night sky. And it's easier to tell about different UFOs as well. I mean, the night sky is full of activity. Anyone can do it. People might think I'm a bit eccentric, a bit weird, but if you ask me, I'm the only one with a grain of sense, because I'm taking advantage of what is clearly there in the night sky for everyone to do, and I'm learning about it. I've got some photos of UFOs that I've taken, if you'd like to see.
Right, this is what we call the Frisbee type. You can't see it very clearly here, it's quite blurred, but if we have a look at a clearer picture, as you can see here, it's very clearly defined as the shape of a Frisbee. That's why I call it so. And see another one here, it's a Commons UFO, and I took these in a park. Yes. Here we can, the reason why this photo looks all blurred It's because the UFO was emitting a lot of energy at the time. It was also emitting a lot of sound when I took it, and so that it provides this crazy image. But it's one of my favourites, and it gives you an insight to what's going on out there. Here you can see what looks like a white blurred light, but what it actually is a means for the UFO to protect itself. So when you take the snap, it releases this light so that you can't see its image. You can't see this with the naked eye, only if you're using photography. But it's quite interesting. This is just a flyby. You can see the beautiful patterns that the spaceship makes as it flies around. It really is an art. It's beautiful. I love it. Right, this is a classic. It's very rare to get this. I hope you can see this clearly, because the UFO is, you can see it leaving Earth. You can see it going off up into space. I hope you can see that. And then see this wiggly line here? That's the spaceship leaving orbit. And as you can see, the patterns it makes really are incredible. It's out of this Earth.
In order for us to see for ourselves, Nathaniel invited us to accompany him on a hunt. We knew then that it would be a journey into the unknown.
Show us the guiding light, show us the guiding light. I must admit you gave me a fright out there on that frosty night. Show us the guiding light, show us the guiding light. Wow, I must admit you gave me a fright. Have no fear, we'll be here tonight.
That was my song I sing when I'm looking for aliens. It attracts their attention. They pick up things, and it's a way to show that we're here for them. If you were to ask me what I thought aliens looked like, obviously they're the aliens that I've met. You know, they're 5'2", quite small, with long fingers with round bits on the ends. But obviously not aliens are going to look like that. There are other aliens. Maybe we won't recognise some of them. Maybe they'll just be spectrums of light. You know, show us the guiding light, spectrums of light. I mean, there are a lot of things that have intelligence out there that we wouldn't recognise as intelligent life forms. There could be bits of rock floating out in space. But there are creatures that we're going to recognise as aliens, and they will teach us. They will teach us about the future, because I've met them. So it's just a matter of time, really. And then... Shut up. Did you hear that? Hang on.
Aliens are coming.
Sorry.
Me, I'm coming along, it's right on. It's the coming. Wait for me while I get my gun. Bang, bang, what'd you do that for? They were only here to meet us. You don't know that.
I'm pretty sure I heard something. It's a sound I recognise. I've heard it before, definitely. Shut up!
Oh, come on!
No.
How many chances did you get?
I just tripped up, man.
Oh, come on, for God's sake,
boys!
What a waste!
Don't worry about it, I've got loads of footage at home. Right. This is the frisbee type I was talking about. As you will see, it's got quite a strange flying pattern. It goes up and then down. It's quite common. At first I wasn't sure if this was a UFO, because it appeared to be moving too slowly for usual UFO movement. But as we'll see in a minute, it starts to speed up, and I realised it was a UFO. It's also quite a common
type of UFO. I've seen many of them. Right, listen to this sound. It's alien broadcasting. Do you see that? That's the flash of energy that I was talking about. Some UFOs give it off as like a means to protect themselves. It's quite rare to see this. This appears to be a plane, but actually it's a UFO, because many UFOs disguise themselves as planes in order to protect themselves so that they can't be identified. I could tell it was a UFO because the readings strongly suggested that it wasn't a plane. Oh, this is probably the best footage I've got of a UFO. I took it outside my bedroom window. It's evidence, if you ask me, conclusive evidence.
Can I have a return to Charing Cross, please? Thanks. I'm going to go and see the government.
The government?
Yes.
What about?
Aliens.
In a new effort to make his voice heard, Nathaniel has found the courage to approach the government and risk ridicule in search of the truth.
I've been asking people if they recognise this picture, but I've got a petition for people to sign. Anyway.
Oh,
no, there's nothing to fear. They're friendly. Thank you very much.
How do you know they are?
Well, I've met them, and there's nothing to be afraid of.
Well, Robbie, you met them than me.
Thank you.
I'm quite excited at the moment because I'm going to go and confront the government about aliens, and I've got a petition that I want people to sign so that the government can know that the people want to know the truth about aliens. So I'm quite excited. I'm up for it. Yeah. It's getting quite dark now, so they should be closing down the government offices and opening the aliens bureau, because it starts quite late. So we've got quite a high chance of talking to some important people about the matters concerning aliens. Here comes our train. On the train, trying to get some signatures to show the government. It's quite empty, but should be okay. Oh, thank you very much.
I believe in aliens.
All right, let's get a pen.
It soon became apparent that he may find more support for his cause than he expected.
Going home. All right. Show us the guiding lights, show us the guiding light. Wow, must I? That's great.
Do you want to sign?
Sorry to bother you, I don't suppose you could sign a petition for me. I'm going up to the government because I want them to know the truth about aliens, and I'm going to go to the government and show them the petition. Would you sign it for me? Yeah. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Where shall I sign?
No, just put your name there. Your name's fine. You don't have to put anything else. I don't know why some people put their addresses there, but...
Put my name?
Yeah, that's great.
Got a pen?
Yeah. Sorry about that. Thank you very much. Going to the government because I want them to know the truth about aliens and I need support.
That's all right, I'm okay.
They're coming, aliens.
Absolutely.
We've got to wise up.
Okay.
Just face the music and dance, really.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to the government to tell them that aliens are coming and I need support. It's no joke, I mean, would you, sir, sign my petition?
What?
It's, I believe that aliens are out there, and well, I've met some in this photo, and I want the government to know that it's the truth. I mean, you know, all I'm asking for is a name so that I can have support on this matter. Would you sign for me?
No.
No. Thank you. Excuse me, would you sign my petition?
Beg your pardon?
Would you sign my petition?
Did I sign it?
Yes.
Let me have a look at it.
Thank you. Sorry for taking up your time.
That's okay. Petition. Beckenham Alien Research Centre. We, the undersigned, believe that the government should make all known information regarding alien activity public. I love X-Files, but quite honestly...
Oh, the X-Files are a joke. They're mocking it. I mean, this is serious. It's big time. They're going to come and, you know, people should know.
I mean, it would be wonderful if there was extraterrestrial life.
There is.
But, you know, and I love science fiction, but to be quite honest with you, there's no evidence. Everything that's been talked about by the public has been, in fact, disproved by governments, whether it's the United States government or this government.
But think about all the alien sightings there have been. There have been millions. If just one of those people are right, then aliens are there. And they are.
Well, I believe that we can't be the only living beings in this universe. But whether there are aliens...
It is a leap of faith, and I've taken that leap. But thank you for signing my petition anyway. I appreciate
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yeah. Show us the guiding lights. Show us the guiding light. Wow.
Aliens?
Yes.
What, from outer space? Or?
Well, yes, from outer space, from the universe. I've got a photo of my aliens, but I'm not getting much support on it at the moment, but would you sign it for me?
What do you want me to do? What does it say?
There you go.
We the undersigned believe that the government should make all known. Really? Why?
Because we want the people to know the truth about this matter. We want them to know that aliens have landed.
How do you know that?
It's like, well, I've seen them, I've met them.
Where?
Well, the first sighting.
On this train accident? Well, on this line?
No, there are no aliens on this line. They don't make themselves known. They're not stupid. They don't want everyone to know they're there. But they're friendly, and they don't want to have a confrontation with us. They when I met aliens, the first time was when I was 14. They were very friendly. They want to learn, and we should learn from them. It's the only way we're going to progress. We've conquered the Earth. We need to conquer the universe now, and we can only do it with their help.
How long has this petition been going for? You just started today.
Yes, on this train.
What?
On this train,
I'm going up to
the government now.
Yes. How successful do you think you'll be?
I'm hoping that at least they'll listen to us. I mean, I've tried before and I've just been...
Have you approached your MP?
Sorry?
Have you approached your MP?
No, I haven't approached my MP. It's new, my ideas to approach the government. I spent most of my time just trying to get research, gain evidence, but it's hard because people just think you're a nutter, but thank you very much for your support anyway. I'm getting quite excited now. We're outside Charing Cross. We've got the petition, we've got a lot of names, a lot of support. It's getting dark, so the Alien Bureau should be opening up quite soon, and let's go, let's do it. Believe it, we're actually here. Look, there's Big Ben. That's where we're heading. Right, we're outside the Ministry of Defence. We've got the petition. We're going to go and see if we can get in and give it to someone of importance. Let's do it. I've got a petition about aliens.
Oh, yeah.
I was wondering if I could show it to anyone.
Okay.
I was wondering if I could show it to anyone.
Show it to who?
Someone in the Ministry of Defence. We exercise our democratic rights. Exercise our democratic rights.
The people have put these signatures on and they want us to take it. Yeah. We said we're going to do this. We're
we're letting them down if we don't. You can go in and give it over the counter.
That's the best.
Yeah? I mean, like,
is that right?
But don't film him now.
I won't film.
Okay, I'm pretty pleased with what's happened because, you know, democracy's good because we gave in the piece of paper and it's addressed to Mr. G. Robinson, who hopefully can do something about it, who will hopefully read it and realise that we're serious and we want things to be done, people to find out the lies that they're keeping in there about aliens. So it's a job well done. It's good. It's good news. Okay, great. Thank you very much. Yes. Yeah?
What are you actually filming?
Place
just
up,
lift your hat up. Interesting beard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nothing suspicious.
All right. Yeah, okay.
Thank you, officer.
Just that you understand this, the nature of the area that you're filming in, that's all.
Yeah, we're just going now.
Okay.
Well, we had a little run-in just then with the police, but they soon saw that we had legitimate democratic business to be done. And it was okay in the end. I mean, what can I say? We've done what we set out to do. It's good. Yes, well done. Everybody took part.
If I were to sum up my hopes for the future, it would be to show people that there are aliens out there. It's no joke. They're out there. I've met them. There's nothing to be afraid of, that's for sure. They want to learn from us, and we will have to learn from them. For us to proceed in this world, we have to learn about what's going on out of this world, and we can only learn that from aliens. And also, the younger generations, I want to teach them at an early age that it's not just the Earth, it's the universe.